Hi, my name is Rachel and I'm a registered nurse and midwife.
Hi, I'm Aliyah and I'm a registered nurse.
And this is Off Shift with Airmed.
How was your placement experience?
So, my last placement that I did, it was last May. It was a crazy ward, but I really loved it there. It was a general medicine ward.
Why was it crazy?
Honestly, you were just walking the whole shift, running around, a lot of code blue, so you learnt a lot there. Yeah. But I'm there for my graduate year, for my first rotation,
so I'm excited.
I'm going to learn a lot. But yeah, how was your last placement?
My last placement was a bit hectic. We had to try and get all our births finished for midwifery.
Yeah.
But over the past 4 years, I did a mixture of nursing and midwifery. So I've seen everything that you've been through, plus my midwifery side. But no, it was all good and it was definitely all worth it. Yeah.
That's good. What like part of the hospital were you in doing your placement?
A lot of it was in the birth suite. All last year was birth suite. And then before that, I've done GED Med. I've done emergency room. ED, I loved it. I wish I was doing it this year. But, and then everywhere, theatre, everywhere else.
So Rach, like what inspired you to become a nurse?
So I've always wanted to be a nurse since I was 8 years old. So my dad spent a lot of time in hospital before he passed away from cancer. So before he passed away, he said to me that he really loved the nurses. He loved how much they cared for him. And he said that he really wished that one of his four daughters would become a nurse. So I decided to do it. And then the midwifery part sort of just came after it because I love babies. I want to be a mum. I love birth. Yeah. What about you? What inspired you?
Mine's not as sentimental as you are, but for example, my mum's a nurse, so I've grown up around it. A lot of my aunties are nurses as well.
Oh, yeah.
So every time we'd hang out with our families, like it's always just about nursing. Mm-hmm. So at the start, I didn't originally want to be a nurse, but since COVID happened, it just so happened that I fell into nursing. Yeah. And ever since then, I've loved doing it, love helping people. So
what is your mum think? Is she happy?
Mum wasn't that happy because of all the back problems that can happen when you're a nurse.
The
back problems.
yeah.
But she's happy now. She's glad that we can share scrubs together.
Are you working together?
Same hospital, but not the same ward. But yeah.
Can you share a heartwarming story from your nursing experience that has stayed with you?
I don't have a specific one, but I just feel like when the patient's families appreciate the work that the nurses do for their family members, I think it's really nice, and they bring us chocolates and cakes.
Donuts.
Yeah, they do. But it's so good. Like, it just makes you feel a bit more appreciated, especially all the stuff that we have to go through in nursing.
Yeah, 100%.
What about you? Do you have anything?
Well, I always get a tear in my eye every time the babies are born because just seeing the dad, I think the dad's reaction and... They always cry every time and just like seeing the mum and the dad together with the baby and taking photos for them and everything. I think that's the most rewarding thing out of the whole experience. And then yes, we do get cake. I got a massive cake
it's
the other
a universal
day,
thing.
Just donuts, everything, but yeah, gifts and
stuff. Do you ever sob along with the dads when
they
see the baby?
I think I've cried with every single birth that I've been in because it's just such an amazing moment. But yeah.
I love that. So what's the most unexpected skill that you've gained from nursing?
Well, how to birth a baby. I think that if I was in a situation by myself, I'd be able to
do it myself, definitely.
I think. I think that the biggest thing that I've gained is probably having patience. I'm a very impatient person. And I think over these past 4 years and starting to work in the hospital now these past 2 weeks, I've definitely learned how to be patient because that's pretty much the best thing to do with dealing with a lot of different people and different personalities.
Do you feel like that just applies in work or do you take that
when I go home, but dealing with like all my siblings and my boyfriend, I don't think I have it at home, but I think in the hospital scenario, I'm great with it. What about you?
Probably the most unexpected skill is time managing because I'm a very late person to everything.
Yeah.
For example, coming here today.
You were late.
Coming here today, I was late.
But,
so time managing, like, especially when you in a morning shift, you have to shower four or five patients, depending if you're short. Yeah. So how fast you can shower one, obviously safe.
How fast you can do it.
But yeah, it's a good skill to have, because now I take shorter showers.
Yeah. If you could change one thing about the healthcare system based on your experience, what would it be?
I think in general, especially when, I don't know if you can probably relate, but when we were studying, just when we go on placements, just having to drop your everyday job that's making money. And you don't get paid on placement, which I think was a little bit tough sometimes, especially when we were on for five week blocks. I'm pretty sure, what about you, midwifery is?
Well, I've done 6 week blocks, I'm on 8 week blocks. I was continuous last year trying to finish all my births and everything, so definitely having to drop everything and then do placement, and it kind of takes away your social life as well.
100%. Even parking situation. A lot of the hospitals don't have free parking, and sometimes you'll have to park really far. Like if there's a train station nearby, you have to park at the train station. If you finish late, you have to walk
15-minute walk.
Yeah, in the dark, and it's a bit scary.
Finishing at 9:30 and having to walk back.
So I think, I think to change something about the future nurses, I think that'd be the best thing for them, so they're all looked after, because at the end of the day, nurses are the backbone of the healthcare system, 100%. I feel.
Yes, no, 100%, I agree.
So how do you maintain a sense of humour or positivity when you're faced with a challenging situation?
I think with my own personality, I feel like in challenging situations and hard situations, I'm always
you laugh.
I just
we've known each other for too long. You definitely laugh in very hard situations.
Exactly, but I think it's in like it's in a good way as well, because then with my patients, like I just crack jokes and I try and you know free wax when you do the IV cannulas and everything. But just having like building a connection with your patients and like being able to crack little jokes here and there, and being able to like adapt to different personalities and everything. I think when people are going through hard times, you just try and, I don't know, be there for them and just be funny, I don't know, just things like that.
I think especially in the hospital situation, you have to have a sense of humour, because if you don't laugh, you'll start crying.
Exactly.
And the patients can 100% sense it as well. If you're stressed, they can get stressed. So I feel like just smiling, laughing along with them, just trying to make something happy and bright in the situation.
What's a common misconception about nursing that you'd like to debunk?
I think all of us in the healthcare system have watched Grey's Anatomy. And to anybody that's not in the healthcare system, that is exactly how it's not happening in the hospital at the moment.
All those deaths of doctors and everyone just,
Like them breaking every single rule that we've learned in nursing school. 100%. It does not happen like that. No. I don't know. Like,
and the doctors do not do all those.
Yes, they do not.
The doctors, but a lot of the things that they were doing in that show, I think the nurses
100%
would do a lot more, and they should have been more of the forefront of that show. But
Grey's Anatomy is not real.
Some of the medical stuff in it as well was just like not.
Doesn't
correct,
actually happen.
But whatever. Let it slide. Still a good show though.
Yes,
so.
We love that show. Still but good. No. Can you describe a day in your life as a nurse that was particularly memorable?
I think every day is always different. There's always something new going on. But I think being in the midwifery role, every day is memorable. You know, we're here, like I'm not bringing life into the world, but like I'm delivering life into the world, and I'm bringing in like a new family member, creating a family. Yeah. And I think to remember that what I have at home is I have a jar, and it's got like
the pink and the blue.
I get pink and blue like little beads in it to like count how many babies I've delivered. So I think collecting that helps to create amazing memories for myself.
I love
that. But every day is different, and every day brings a new memory and new skills and new life lessons and everything. So you would be completely a little bit different.
I feel like I'm on the opposite end. So because I work in a very acute ward, sometimes dealing with families that have just had a family member pass away, like they're pretty memorable, because especially when you're doing end of life care for a patient, like you really have to bond with the family, be there for them. So I feel like those kind of moments have stuck with me a little bit more.
So what advice would you give to someone just starting their nursing career?
I think the biggest thing is just get through it. Like
Persevere.
That's the best way. I mean, we've known each other for 17 years now, and we were lucky enough to go through nursing school together.
Yeah.
But I feel like number one tip is just make sure you have some good support system around you. Make friends. I know it's a bit daunting.
Uni's scary. Uni can be, but it's definitely worth it.
100%.
Having someone there, especially because with classes, I wouldn't go to classes unless you were there.
Exactly.
So we sort of.
Yeah,
made
and you make friends.
Exactly,
and then you get allocated to the same placement together. At least you have that. But yeah, trust me. I feel like nursing school went so quickly for us.
Yeah.
Yes and no.
Yeah.
Yes and no.
But yeah. I would say just. Do it.
Yeah.
Do what you want to do. Do the double degree. Do your whatever post-grad, whatever.
Yeah.
Do anything that you want to do. It's definitely worth it in the end to build your career up and do what you love.
So how do you balance the emotional demands of nursing with your at-home life?
I think in my personal life and dealing with what goes on at work, it's important to have a support system at home.
Yeah.
So I have a big family, so there's a lot of people to go to always.
I know.
Always someone to annoy me, but even having, you know, being with a partner and everything, you always have someone to share things with and they're there to emotionally support you.
Yeah.
With whatever you've gone through. And what about you?
I think just knowing where to draw the line. So, because nursing is a very emotionally demanding job. So, leaving work at work and just relaxing when you get home. So, even if that's just like put a face mask on, watch some Netflix, see your favorite person. Yeah, exactly. Go out, go on a road trip.
Have a drinky poo.
Yes. After work.
After work when you don't have few shifts on, but definitely all those things.
Yeah, but definitely reward yourself, even treat yourself every so often, like just to make you happy.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Buy those new scrubs.
Yeah, buy the new scrubs. These ones.
Yeah, these ones. What's the most important lesson you've learned from your patients?
You learn a lot from your patients. You learn patience from your patients.
Yeah.
But true. I think the biggest thing is, especially working in an acute ward, they're at their lowest lows. So just knowing how to still smile, be resilient, and just look up, be happy. Mm. You know, they're still able to crack jokes with you. So that's why I think it's really important to be happy around your patients as well, because you really learn how to bounce back, I guess. Even if you've been having a stressful shift, just your patients are always going to be lovely to you. Not always, but most times, if you, what you give is what you get back, I feel like.
Having that therapeutic relationship with them as well, creating those connections. But no, I agree 100%. I think, the best thing as well that I've learnt from a lot of patients is that nurses do have an important role in their care.
Yes, they do.
And changing, making a difference in their life. Because I think growing up, I always had this conception that, you know, nurses don't do that much. They're just there for showers, they're there to change your nappy, you know, things like that. But they've actually got so much to do in the life of a patient and giving them the best care possible. And
So what are your go-to self-care practices after a really hard day at work?
After a day of work, I'm always at the gym after, when I can be bothered. I do a really good gym session and then I'll have a sauna. And in the sauna, I can really reflect on my day and think about what's gone wrong, what's gone good. And then once I'm all relaxed, I'll go home, have a healthy dinner, do my skincare, see my family, see my boyfriend, and then watch some Desperate Housewives.
And I still need to start that because you keep talking about it.
Amazing. So good.
When I get home, I just feel like having the longest, hottest shower ever.
Yes.
It doesn't matter what the water bill is.
Yeah. Do a sauna.
I don't have a sauna though.
No, go to the gym, do a sauna. It's so worth it.
Maybe I'll have to.
Anyway.
But even just going home and then doing your skincare, like putting a face mask on.
Makes a difference.
Yeah, it does. Laying in bed with your favorite person, I feel like.
And N95s on.
Yeah. After having
breakouts.
Yes, N95 on for the whole day just kills your skin. So I feel like skincare is so important. And you just feel like you're doing something good for yourself after a hard day.
Exactly.
Yeah.
How has nursing changed your perspective on health and wellness?
I think in nursing school, they teach you about looking after yourself. Mm-hmm. It's always put yourself first before the patient.
So yeah.
Like we've got a lot of practices in nursing, for example, just your back as well.
Yep.
Like I
manual
mentioned
handling,
earlier. Manual handling.
Low beds.
Low beds.
Definitely a no-no.
Yeah, and you never lift a patient with your whole body. Like
yep.
You have to
the
make
machines.
It. Yeah, the machines. Yeah, the hoist. The Serasteadies.
Yeah.
So that helps a lot, I feel like.
Just, yeah. Taking care of yourself.
Yeah,
like
I think with my
one.
Mum as well, because she had to get steroid injections because of her sore back, like her shoulder was
yeah.
torn. So I think just keeping that in the back of my mind just
yeah.
to make sure that we look after our bodies as well.
Taking care of yourself, keeping yes. up with the manual handling education classes
yeah,
and things like that.
I think we forget.
Oh,
a lot of 100%. Nurses forget. And
yeah.
And then you
I'll come home from my back's just like
exactly.
Oh. And I'm just like, oh, far out. Should have yeah. put the bed up. I think for me, yeah, a big thing that's changed my perspective on health and wellness is definitely taking care of myself. And also that, you know, who knows what the day can bring, and
yeah.
you may have plans for tomorrow, but then something else
too
might
tired.
Happen.
Yeah. Yeah.
So always do what you have planned, because you never know what's going to happen tomorrow. But definitely learned that doing placement in the ED. So seeing all the things that came in, I'm just
it's
like, oh,
crazy. Yeah.
Imagine if that was me. But yeah, definitely take care of yourself.
If you hadn't become a nurse, what profession do you think you would have taken up?
Well, my dream job, it's weird, is to be a florist. I don't know why, just being surrounded by flowers all day and plants just... I don't know.
I can't relate. I have hay
something.
Fever.
Oh,
so.
Well, there you go. But I just love flowers. So
yeah.
Get me flowers if you want to send me flowers. But no. And then also just being a stay-at-home mum, I think.
You've always loved
I've
the
always
idea.
Wanted to be a mum growing up with, you know, 7 siblings. I think
yeah.
I've always just
big
wanted
family.
To have my 10 kids and be
yes.
done with it. And yeah.
You still want to do
I
that.
I still want to do that.
Yeah.
So we'll see. But yeah, what about you? What's your dream?
I always wanted to be a flight attendant.
Mm.
I love traveling. Like
yeah.
before COVID here, we were traveling every year. We made
yeah.
it a thing with our family.
Mm-hmm.
So being on the planes all the time, I just thought it was such a fun job. You get to see so
yeah.
many places.
It'd be great.
Dream
yeah. destination?
The Maldives, but it's
oh,
really expensive.
That's, yeah. yeah, 100%.
You never know,
definitely
one day.
Honeymoon spot.
Yeah, it is.
What's one important thing now you'd like to focus on to better your future?
I think just finding more hobbies to do.
Mm-hmm.
Just keeping yourself active, like your brain active all the time, because once you stop, you kind of just become work focused
yeah.
and you get
you're
lost
always,
in your work.
Yeah.
And I feel like you lose your relationships with the people around you as well. So I think just making sure you're checking up on your friends, your family, making plans, going out for dinner,
mm-hmm.
just treating yourself to things. Just,
yeah.
Yeah, because at the end of the day, you're still a person, so...
Exactly. Work's not number one.
Exactly.
Yourself
yeah.
is, so, yeah.
What about
I
you?
I think just to always keep doing, you know, what you love, but also
yeah.
having that balance. And I think one important thing for my future would be to, you know, keep learning, keep doing whatever degrees I want to do, you know, aesthetic nursing or
same.
Maternal child health nurse, like
yeah.
anything like that, just to keep persevering in the career that I love and to
yeah.
never stop and
keep the passion alive.
Keep the passion alive.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. What's your absolute go-to night shift snack?
Oh my God. V's.
Two V's.
Yeah, two,
two
V's. Sugar-free blue V's and the massive
yes,
ones.
Yes, I always
they're
get
the ones
sugar-free, 100%.
Yeah.
500
so,
mil.
Actually, maybe three, because you have one before.
I have a coffee before. I go coffee on the way there.
V.
V at like midnight.
Yeah.
Another
then you
one.
Have it, I have my sleep for an hour, then I'll
yeah.
have another one because I'm really
my sleep's
groggy
not till 4 a.m., so I try and... Yeah, and then V on the way home so I don't... Fresh. In the car again, but yes, and then cheeky Maccas throughout the night as well. I love
throughout the night.
I love when the nurses do a massive
Uber Eats
order, Maccas, and then yeah.
See, I like the red lollies. You know the berries, the red no. berries I used to get at like swim school afterwards.
Swim school.
Yeah, or even after like, or even the strawberries and cream ones.
Oh
just
yes,
the Allen's
no,
lollies.
Yes, any
those
lollies.
Ones. I just
yeah.
smash them throughout the whole
chocolate.
Night.
Chocolate. I feel like I don't eat that much though.
Not a chocolate person though.
Just caffeine.
Yeah, you need a lot of caffeine.
One sleep.
For night shift, so you fall asleep.
Then, yeah, but definitely I love night shifts. I think night shifts are for me. But goodbye to your social life.
Yeah,
but,
you won't, yeah, you're
yeah.
nocturnal by that point as well.
Yeah.
So
exactly.
Yeah.
Have you seen Grey's Anatomy?
Have I seen Grey's Anatomy? Yes, I have.
Of course I have. Well, who's your favourite character?
Oh, I love George in the first early few seasons, and definitely Lexi. Is definitely up there.
McDreamy?
Swoon. Yeah, possibly. Yeah. Which one's McDreamy? Is that
Derek?
Derek. Oh, no, Sloane. I like, what's his name? McSteamy. I love McSteamy. I love McSteamy and Lexi.
And Lexi, yes.
That plain scene,
and then they
definitely
killed them both off the show. So
spoilers, by the way.
Spoilers.
But no, that was definitely hit me hard.
I think Meredith's overrated, I feel like.
Yeah, have you seen her walk?
Yeah.
When she does the thing down the wedding aisle. I think that's hilarious. But I love Grey. I used to like it until the last few seasons.
Yeah, I stopped watching after season 11 or 12.
I think I got up to like 9 or something. Yeah. But it was definitely a good show.
All right, if nursing had a theme song, what do you think it would be?
I think the first thing that comes to mind is obviously the Bee Gees.
Of course.
Staying alive, just because of CPR. Yeah. I think that just plays in my head constantly through all our packs and everything.
Yeah, it's
always
playing in the back of your head.
Yeah, but other than that, I don't know. How to save a life?
Yeah.
The phrase.
That's a classic as well. I feel like a lot of nurses will say that.
But yeah.
I can't think of one off the top of my head. On the way to shift, it's just blasting Taylor Swift.
So
even though you hate her,
cancelled.
But I love her. I don't know, she puts me in a happy mood. She's the best.
Do you get pre-shift anxiety, and what are your ways to prevent this?
I think every nurse, no matter how long they've been in the nursing field for, they always get pre-shift anxiety.
Yeah.
Because you never know what you're going to walk into.
Exactly.
Or even if you do know what you're walking into because you worked the last 3 consecutive days, like you can still get a bit stressed out because you kind of know what you're walking into. But it's like knowing and not knowing will just give you anxiety. Mm-hmm. But when you get to shift, if you see your favourite, like, you know, you're working with a good team, you know, people are cracking jokes with you. Like, I feel like it goes away. And by the end of the shift, you'll be like, why did I even get stressed?
I know. I'm always, when I'm on my way to work driving, I think, even before that, when I'm getting ready for work, I always get ready too early. And then I'm sitting
around.
Yeah, I'm sitting at home in my scrubs and I'm just like, oh God, like what am I going to walk into today?
Yeah.
And I'm just like, oh, can I do this? But then I get there.
It's fine.
And it's fine. Yeah, I think, starting as baby nurses.
Yeah, I feel like there's a lot of anxiety for grads.
It's definitely
as well.
Scary and, you know, starting to do things by yourself and giving medications and all that.
So yeah.
Scary, but.
But it's good. We have a lot of support as well, so that helps just.
But I feel like, I was speaking to a midwife the other day and they've been in the industry for so long and they said every shift they go to as well, they get pre-shift anxiety, so it's normal.
It's a given. What's your favourite movie and TV show at the moment and why?
I have 2 favourite movies, Devil Wears Prada Legend with Tom Hardy, because Tom Hardy is just up there for me.
Spunk.
You have to watch it. But favourite TV show at the moment, definitely Desperate Housewives.
Couldn't tell.
Always something happening, crazy stuff, and just always, you know, to keep you on your feet. But on your toes, sorry, not on your
toes.
Feet, on your toes. Anyway, what's your favourite at the moment?
At the moment, I'm rewatching Brooklyn Nine-Nine. And I know you don't like Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
I do like it, it's just mid.
It's just so light-hearted, it's easy, and like, Holt's funny. It's just, the dry humour is so good.
Yeah.
But I think my favourite movie at the moment, a bit controversial, is Saltburn.
Saltburn. I
loved it.
It was. It had some good, memorable moments in it.
It really kept the brain active the whole movie. Yeah. So I feel like it was an interesting watch.
Yeah. What's the funniest or most memorable thing a patient has said to you or done to you?
Well, there's nothing in particular that comes to mind. It's just kind of like a broad thing. But you don't really expect things to be thrown at you. Bodily fluids to be flung at you. It's a lot, but you
it's
definitely
all in a
remember.
Day's work, though.
Yeah, you definitely remember every time something's come flying at you. Definitely. But you really learn how to dodge things at one point.
Yeah.
So, good. What about you?
You'd be a good dodgeball player.
Yeah, I would. Probably.
I think the most funniest or most memorable is just patients trying to set you up with their family members, yep, or you know, the doctors or anyone in their vicinity.
It does happen quite a bit, actually.
It does, yeah, but
memorable.